Assalamualaikum. Welcome all to Easy Humanitum channel. In this video, I discuss difference between granular and agranular leukocyte. At the end of the video, I give some important MCQ question to test your knowledge. The leukocyte are two type, agranular and granular. Within the agranular leukocytes, two cells are present, lymphocyte and monocyte. And granular leukocyte are three type, eosinophil, basophil and neutrophil. The granular leukocyte contain numerous granule or tiny sacs within the cytoplasm that contain enzyme that digest microorganism. This is eosinophil contain granules, this is neutrophil and this is basophil. The agranular leukocyte have few or no granules in the cytoplasm. This is lymphocyte, this is monocyte. The granular leukocyte contain lobulated nucleus. This is the neutrophil contain multiple lobulated nucleus and multiple lobe present within the nucleus. And eosinophil usually contain bilobed nucleus and basophil also contain bilobed nucleus. And this nucleus is difficult to see due to the presence of irregular shape granules. The agranular leukocyte, this is monocyte. The shape of the nucleus is kidney shape or bean shape, and lymphocyte nucleus is spherical. The lifespans of the granular leukocytes about 12 hours. The lifespans of agranular leukocyte is longer than the granular leukocyte, and it's several weeks to years. The granular leukocytes are all capable of amoeboid movement. In agranular leukocyte, a crawling like type of movement seen in lymphocyte, accomplished by the protrusions of the cytoplasm of the cell involving the formations of the pseudopodia. This is the pseudopodia. The percentage of the white blood cell in the blood smear, the granular leukocyte contain 55 to 70% of total white blood cell, and agranular leukocyte 20 to 30%. And these are the percentage of the granular leukocyte, and this is the percentage of agranular leukocytes. The diameter of the granular leukocyte, agranular leukocyte it's little bit bigger than the granular leukocytes. These are the diameter of granular leukocytes, this is the diameter of agranular leukocytes. The granular leukocyte contain enzyme histamine and heparin, which are important in inflammation, allergic reaction and asthma. The eosinophil are helped to fight against disease. Their number increase in our body during a parasitic infections, a allergic reaction or a state of cancer. The agranular leukocyte helps our body to fight against disease and external infection through phagocytosis and making antibody. The granular leukocyte, they are part of innate immunity. This cell can kill a germ, but once the germ is dead, the innate immune system forget it. It does not communicate any information about the germ to the rest of the body. So you see, this is the neutrophil, this is the bacteria, and this is the degranulations. The granulation is liberate and attacked the bacteria, and the neutrophil also capable of phagocytosis. The lymphocytes are the part of the adaptive immunity. They can recognize antigen and produce antibody to fight the antigen. They can memorize the antigen, and in future they can recognize and attack the antigen more quickly. So this immunity is at first is slow, but in future the response is quick. And innate immunity is a quick immune response is observed. Special note, special point about monocyte. monocyte and macrophage are number of the mononuclear phagocytic system, a component of innate immunity. So test your knowledge. Identify A, B, C, D, and E cell. So this is neutrophil, multiple lobes observed. This is basophil, this is eosinophil, this is lymphocyte, and this is monocyte. Which of the following white blood cell is capable of phagocytosis? Basophil, eosinophil, lymphocyte, neutrophil. The answer is neutrophil. Which of the following is the function of the white blood cell? Transport oxygen, maintain hemostasis, defense against infections, produce hemoglobin. The answer is defense against infection. What is degranulation? Degranulation is the cellular process that releases antimicrobial cytotoxics or other molecule from the secretory vesicle called granule from inside some cell. It is used by several different cells involved in the immune system, including granulocytes, neutrophil, basophil, eosinophil, and mast cell. It is also used by certain lymphocytes such as natural killer cell and cytotoxic T cell. Those main purpose is to destroy invading microorganism. So this is all about this video. If you like this video, please share this video and subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching.